Hello Gundam fans, this is Brown92, and today I'll be looking at the SD Valkylander from Gundam Build Divers Rerise. So this is the prerequisite SD kit in the team. And this is the Dragon Mode, very cool looking. Gun Dragon? I guess it makes sense, Gundam, Gun Dragon. Okay, I get it. Also known, Par. The pilot calls it Morgiana, and in both modes, just like the model itself. Not really sure why. Maybe we'll know why in season 2. But yeah, it's a really good dragon mode. It's pretty solid. Got quite a few stickers. You got the forehead jewel, the eyes, all the metallic green on the body, the big yellow here, which these are obviously supposed to represent the Astrea wings, because this is based off the Astrea, not the Exia. Still don't have a Musha Exia. What the hell, Bandai? Please hurry up. You got yellow stickers here on the tail, also three on the bottom here. Got some gray and green here, a little bit right here, which will be the head. Now, the only thing I don't like about the Dragon Mode is this right here, which I assume is supposed to be, like, the stomach, the soft underbelly, which, it looks okay, like, as it is, but the fact that you have this left over, which will be the chest of the Robot Mode, personally, I much prefer having the armor attached. That way nothing's left over, and it really doesn't look bad with that on. Just more gold. If anything, I think I like it better. Now, articulation-wise, the head does have a hinge to go up and down, and the mouth can open because it can shoot fire out of its mouth. The torso does have a wiggle because of the head is ball-jointed, and the arms are hinged. The legs are ball-jointed, and they can also move forward and back. And out here and rotate. Hinge of the knee, ball jointed ankle, the wings are ball jointed. The tail is also ball jointed because it's going to be the waist. And then because you got the knees and the ankles, you can get the tail to go up. You can tilt it. And you can also rotate here at what will be the weapons. And also bring it down. So, you do have quite a bit of articulation on the Dragon Mode, which I really, in the show, I didn't really like the Dragon Mode. It looked really doofy, but in Moloka form, I like it. So, to turn it into the Mobile Suit Mode, the actual Valkylander Mode, you just have to really take everything off. So we're going to unplug the tail from the feet. They just plug into the inner part here, the inner hole, and then we'll unplug the lower legs from the arms, right there, and then unplug the dragon neck, and then unplug the backpack. Oops, what the heck, oh, that's not good. Hope I didn't break that. I totally broke that. Wow. Yeah, I totally... That was not being... Give me a second. Alright, so a little bit of Gorilla Glue, and we're back in action. So just get the arms rotated, and straighten up the legs, and you are done. That is Valkylander, and it's very awesome. Mobile Suit Mode. I'm not gonna knock off points for that. That was my mistake. But yeah, it looks really good. Now, this is the mode you're gonna have it in. When it's in Dragon Mode, you're supposed to have the eyes blank with the visor down. But this is one of the forms that the Astrea took in 00. That basically had the visor so that somehow other military forces wouldn't know it was a Gundam because it had the green visor. Sure. But to make it look like it does in the show, you just have to pop off the helmet. And then rotate the eyes for the pupils. And then flip in the green visor. There's a little bit of resistance in here. So I'm a little worried the hinge will break because it is clear. But so far, so good. Pop that back on. I do like the metallic green that just goes in here. Reminiscent of the gene condensers in the head. And there is the actual Valkylander. I love the hair. I also love the fact they give you an added piece of gray for the head, so it looks like it's actually braided, like hair. They didn't have to do that. They really didn't. It could have been all red, but they gave you a separate piece. Something old SDs would never do. You also have the camera back there in the front. Nice clear piece for the chest. Got the gold here on the arms for stickers. They got the stickers here. Yeah, it looks really good. I love how this looks without the armored up mode. Although, to make it into the, Gene Dragon Fuse mode, I think it is, all I have to do is bring in the backpack. And it is a little different in Molson mode, so take the wings off, take the legs, and take the feet off. And then the ball joints above them are tabs, and it's the same tabs that were in the arms. So, put those in there. And right there. And then the wings, they were in this ball joint, or ball socket, now they're going in here. Oh, actually, we'll do that after we connect it. So now it's going into the back instead of the head. Then we can connect the wings. And this time the wings, or the stairs, are facing forward. And then the claws just go into these, the high heels just go into the back of the claws. Oh, I didn't have it in the right spot. Because it'll actually be flush with the gold. And that is the Dragon Fusion mode, which looks really good. Personally, I like it unarmored. That's just me, though. It is going to be a little more bulk, but I'm really, really looking forward to the avalanche armor. Also, the wings don't stay on the best because there's that gap there, so they can face forward, where before it was a whole socket. So they can still move, but not a whole bunch. Now, in terms of articulation, you do have the ball-jointed head, which is still pretty good, even if you have the backpack on. You have the ball-jointed hair. You got the ball jointed shoulders with the polycap in the torso so it can come forward some. The arm is ball jointed, the elbow is hinged, ball jointed wrist, you got a nice ball jointed waist, ball jointed legs, you got the knee bend, and ball jointed ankles. And the wings can move, but they are a little hindered. They can mostly come out. And when you have them come out, then you can rotate them. But if you have them facing more forward, they have to go to the cut joint so they can't move down. So it does have good articulation, and it doesn't use the cross silhouette frame. It's more of a cross between the kits from like Unicorn. I'm also thinking of the Wing Gundam EW articulation and the BB Legend line, something like that, because it does have the knees and the elbows, but it doesn't have like the neck hinge or the cross silhouette inner frame, or the joints you can pull out in the torso is the polycaps instead of the joints, but it's still pretty good. Now, weapon wise, well, we can take the tail and pull this part out, and we got the what's it called, the Gian Gun Sword, which is just a sword. It's not a gun. You could have it. Kind of like a gun. Like with this peg, but it's a sword. And then we have the shield. Now I think this is supposed to go into the center. And then you can take the dragon head and plop it on the top. And you have the Gian gun shield. Sure, why not? It looks really cool. I like how this looks. And then you got the neck and the rest of the tail. So this is the Gian gun launcher, or Gian launcher, whatever it is. It's basically the Gian cannon, the Gian mega cannon, I think, from the Astria. So you have to take one of the legs, and you'll notice there's grooves in here, and they will fit right into these little tabs. Slide right in, and that was the handle. And with this, this is the Gian proto rifle. So, straight up the peg here for the barrel. Get that back. Take the other leg. This is a really ingenious thing. I really like how they did this. It's very solid. And it's just a good use of parts. Now you have the rifle. So, you can have a sword, a shield. You can have the gun and cannon. You can mix and match. So, really, really cool to incorporate all of the Astria's weapons in a dragon. And they look pretty accurate. Although, you can combine the two guns into the, I think it's the Mega Flare, because this is like the Flare Rifle or something. The names are weird. But anyways, you gotta take the handle out of here and stick it back onto the side. And then just jam the cannon in the back, a la Strike Freedom. And now it's combined. And with this, you can actually do two-handed. So this is the way the Astria red frame and gold frame combination should have done it. Because look how easy that is. Looks pretty natural and super simple. There we go. And if you want, get back in there. Yeah, I don't like these polycap. I never have, but that's what they use. Not a big deal. But if you want, you can always put the sword back on the shield. And now you have all the weapons together. And this is more like the Astria or Exia shield, because you can actually flip it back because it's pegged in. I think that, which I don't think it ever did. I don't think the pictures are in the instructions, but that is how I'm going to do it. Because it pleases me. So that's everything. And that is pretty great. Now let's finish with quite a few comparisons. We'll start with the, I was going to do the Earth 3, but I think I'll do the Core Gundam. Now that I have an extra Core Gundam right now, I might as well utilize it. So you can see how close they are in height. And then we can use another Gundam from Build Fighters. The I think it's the SD Red Warrior. I think it's just called that. And so it is the Valkylander is a smaller SD. If you look at it here compared to the SD double diver, which is the cross silhouette inner frame. You can see the difference. And then compared it to the original Exia SD, it is also smaller. It is heightened because of the claws and bulked out with the backpack. But then comparing it to the EX standard Exia, if it didn't have the claws on, I should have done them with the claws, but it's more of a close height when it's in its base mode. So, hopefully we get a 00 and an Exia soon. I think, are we getting a 00, a normal one? In cross silhouette. But I want an Exia. Give me at least a Musha Exia, if anything. Because you got a great kit here. This is a wonderful kit. It looks good in both modes. I love the mobile suit mode. the fact that we got a Musha Astrea before an Exia is, I think, a first, because usually you get the Exia, and then they convert it into the Astrea, even though chronologically in 00, the Astrea came first. It was like a test bed for the weapons for the Exia. But, I mean, this is the Astrea F-type, I should say. Maybe they'll do a white version, and do the normal Astrea, who knows. But yeah, it gives me hope for it. I want a good Exia, because the ones we have are not nearly as good as what we can have now. But anyways, that's about it, and I'll see you in the next review.